Hey there, Chart friends. Lamont here from Chart Guys. Almost forgot my name there. Lamont here from Chart Guys. Checking in on the electric vehicle sector. We should probably not start in the 5 minute time frame. So starting off with Tesla, our big dog. Bulls seeing a little bit of daily bounce follow through today. After defending this shelf of support here, let's just zoom into the ideally they haven't changed the hourly trend bearish to already set this daily lower high here, but we are looking up at daily resistance of 445.23 on the hourly time frame. Hourly trend looks okay, bit of a choppy start here with a sideways day, but today seeing some follow through pullback for a healthy higher low. Ideally bulls will see some more follow through tomorrow and break over this high here of 430.50 to see some more daily bounce follow through with some more hourly trend change follow. Okay, so perhaps a bit of a channel to be on watch in the short term as we head up to test 445.23 resistance. This is a really nice back test, huh, of these previous tops here. I'm telling you, this is one of the easiest ways to trade. It's just marking off these major levels and then maybe use a low. So since we use tops there, and then you use a low and then just draw your range off of that and stop out if that low gets taken out, since that was the last higher low, right? So if you're trying to catch the trend play, one of the easiest ways, one of the most straightforward ways to do it, in my opinion. Anyway, didn't get that trade, wasn't paying attention to it, in from over there. So what are we looking for tomorrow? Really just bearish plays, top fishing that 445.23. Ideally the bulls can rush up there, get the hourly RSI extended, and then we can be top fishing those levels. That level, 445. Nope, not much. NIO. Stay for NIO. Okay, so bulls maintain this shelf of support. This is exactly why you always want to give a bit of wiggle room for your orders. Things like that, right? Everything is, you know, nothing is static, right? When you're trading these levels, they're not like a fixed level. You gotta allow yourself a bit of wiggle room, especially for low volume names, because low volume names is more likely to wick past levels and then, you know, get back above. Anyway, let's see, check it out on the daily time frame. Trying to confirm this bull flag here. Try to confirm this bull flag, big volume, well, bigger volume than previous days. A good look on the hourly time frame. Hourly trend change in a big way. No real hourly consolidation today. This is pretty much all bulls all day today. So tomorrow we'll be looking for that healthy hourly higher low. And I would love a back test. If the price were to get back down towards the $27 level with 5 minute oversold conditions, like right around here somewhere, that is a trade. That is a good trade in my opinion. Because if we were to break down back after a day like this with all this volume, if we were to break back down to this channel, that would be a big, big red flag. So something like this, I'm not opposed to anything, something like that. Looking for that lower high initially. So a trade like this is very much a good one in my opinion. Because we know we're looking for that healthy hourly higher low, and there's a lot of space to do so. I guess this doesn't make much of a difference. Either way, the fit doesn't make that much of a difference. What I care more about is these tops that got put in here. Bunch of tops. So let's just use top system. So then maybe we'll do it like this. And remember that this trade is based off of RSI. So I won't be scaling into any trades unless that 5 minute RSI is at my back when I'm looking for this hourly higher low. So I just want to see where a 5 minute would get oversold, and it is so far away. So we'll have to see. Ideally, what'll happen tomorrow, what'll happen throughout through the evening, is we'll just cool off the RSI by going sideways or maybe a little bit downwards, and then if we can go sideways a little bit, cool off the RSI, and then dump down tomorrow, that would be the ideal situation for this kind of play. So remember our zone of interest, why we care primarily about 5 minute oversold conditions. So let's say that it won't be oversold down there, then I would just look lower. I wouldn't care about this one so much, and maybe I'll start digging into this one, right? And then my range will be like this, right? It's not to say that you must have RSI in order for price to reverse, but it's just a little bit of an extra edge, right? Not right. Right. No inflection. No upwards inflection. Okie dokie. NIO. That's NIO. NICLA. Nikla, okay, so as expected, just tightening in this EQ here, a daily inside bar today. Let's check out the hourly time frame. Hourly time frame has technically gone bullish. So you do have this trend change, but remember, whenever we're in these daily consolidation sideways patterns, the price action trends, they matter a little less, at least to me. So good volume on the move up. Nice diminishing bear volume on the way down. So a decent look for bulls, but really, really, it's all about this EQ. It's all about how this EQ breaks, and I wouldn't be surprised if Tesla gives us some clues, and if NIO, for example, is giving us clues for this, because they confirmed a bull flag and broke bull, perhaps that is a clue for Tesla, this big EQ slash basing here, to break bull itself. And then if tomorrow NKLA were to break this EQ bullish, and then WKHS were to start their bounce, then we'd be a lot more confident in this Tesla EQ breaking bullish. And you can say the vice versa, right? If the Tesla EQ starts breaking bullish, then we could be confident, we can be more confident and look more bullish in NKLA and WKHS, although the correlation is not, it's not as serious, it's not as intense in compared to other sectors. Okay, so WKHS fallen off a cliff here. Looking for a weekly higher low, are we? No, we're not looking for a weekly higher low because we changed the weekly trend here. So we are not looking for a weekly higher low. Oh, actually, that's the... I wouldn't argue with you too much. Questionable. Weekly trend is questionable. Are we looking for a monthly higher low? Not quite yet. So bears still need to break 1680 to have bulls looking for a... potential monthly higher low over 132. And you know, I certainly don't mean to encourage anybody to just YOLO into a trade, but some of the best trades are these monthly inside bars. When you come down, like ideally it would be weekly or daily oversold, and if you ever zoom out to the monthly and you have weekly and daily oversold conditions and you see a big inside bar, it's typically a good time to buy, because it's just like any other time frame, right? An inside bar is very likely to print if given this much range, because essentially what we're anticipating is just an EQ. So if we look on the weekly time frame, we're anticipating a potential bounce in the near term, and then a lower high, and then maybe some tightening range if the bulls are able to defend these lows, major lows here. Okay, so let's see. We are now flirting with daily oversold conditions. If we could get daily oversold to test this base, I think that would be a great place. And I know I just spoke about a monthly inside bar. It can break by a little bit. It can break by a little. Actually, matter of fact, there's still a bit of space. But it's very common that you'll see like a bit of a break and then a defense, like right here, right? This low broke that low, and then there was a defense. Let's see. Any other instances here? Not really. Here's one, right? Breaks a little bit, and then we see some recovery. So, let's see. 1680. So, if we were to come test this base with daily oversold conditions, I think that's a decent shot, as good a shot as any. Wow, the range is so big on this ticker. Absurd. All right, so let me zoom into the hourly time frame and mark off some more meaningful levels, or maybe the 4 hour. Just want to catch the lowest 4 hour close. Then we'll use this wiki range. There's no price action to the left to help us. Because there's all this air over here, let's see. We only have this local price action to be playing off of, and this is quite a bit of volume to get put in here. And so if when with Daily Oversoul down here, I don't think bottom fishing this base is a bad play by any means. So maybe something like that. And if you don't want to scale in, if you're not comfortable scaling in to weakness, then you could just wait to see. I can almost guarantee you there will be some kind of a reaction. I don't necessarily mean that we'll find a bottom here and then, you know, see all-time highs, but I can almost guarantee you when this base gets tested that it will see some kind of bounce. So if you want, if you want to be patient, what you could do is you could wait for this level to get tested and then maybe make a play off of a hourly higher low after a nice big hourly move to the upside. Interesting trade. So. NEE. Okay, NEE, healthy sideways consolidation as well. It's almost like it's just waiting for the market to see some upside and then it's gonna get ready to go. We will see. Very healthy weekly consolidation, couple of inside bars, daily just sideways after yesterday's defense of these lows on the hourly time frame. It's in a rectangle, huh? A very, very clean rectangle. Nice to test down there. About that. Okay. Alrighty then. So we just have this tightening range. As long as we're range bound, the only plays that I like are bottom fishing these lows, just like that play from over there, and then top fishing those highs. But I don't really love the top fishing plays because this is a very, very healthy consolidation on the weekly and the daily time frame. And so I think the potential of a bull flag is too high that I would care to top fish this range, even though, of course, it did give a decent trade today. I don't care because this could have very easily been the break, right? If we had a strong market day, then that could have been the break. And then in which case, top fishing that range is nuts. Not so advised. Typically, you want to be more careful too when you're playing bearish, right? Again, markets are inherently bullish, right? If you believe that, if you're betting on expansion, if you're betting on human expansion, then in general, the market is bullish. Obviously, you know, individual tickers, it's a little bit of a different story, but the idea is it's just a little bit trickier to go short, in my opinion. Did I just say opinion? In my opinion. Okay, so I would just care about bottom fishing these ranges here. And at this point now, with that nice clean defense, I wouldn't be surprised by like a fake out. Like a break of this support just by a little bit and then recovery. So, something like that. It's essentially the same trade as before, but with a potential stop point incorporated. And I'm just totally eyeballing this. How I'm measuring that range, I'm just estimating, right? Because I know these lows got put in here, I know these levels were significant back here, and I think the hourly would be oversold if it were to get down there from here. Yes, it would be. So this is definitely a play that I think is a reasonable play, essentially the same play as it. Okay, that about does it. Thanks for tuning in, and I will see you all soon.